Good morning. A very warm welcome to St. Martin's this morning, whether you're joining us on our live stream or indeed in the room. Or I was at the darts on Thursday, so I should have said, for those in the room and the millions joining us worldwide. Made even better by the fact that Luke Littler lost. I have to say that was not a popular opinion on the night. I don't know, I can't take to that boy. I never thought I would ever see myself supporting Gerwyn Price at anything, but I was that night. And we came one dart twice from a nine dart finish. Holly and Jacob were gutted because we promised them a fiver if one happened. But at the end of the night, we gave them a fiver anyway because we thought two near misses are as good as a hit, so they were happy. But it was a good night. Just some quick intimations. Our cinema in March, we've moved it to the 8th of March, so that's technically the second Friday rather than the first, but moved it to the 8th of March, and we'll be watching Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. The World Day of Prayer is here on the 1st of March at 11 a.m., and it's been advertised widely throughout the kind of greater Portobello, Duddingston, Craigmillar area. So it'd be good if we had a good representation of our own folks as well. So please, if you could come along on that morning. Sheila Alexander is 90 this week on the 21st, but next Saturday, the family are having an open house for her from 1 till 6. And they're basically inviting anybody just to go in and, just basically spend time and wish her a happy birthday. And that's between 1 and 6 next Saturday. I'm going to go and sing Pour Me Another Tequila, Sheila. I'm no. But everyone's warmly welcomed to that. Still Game is this Friday between from 2 o'clock, and it's a film afternoon, and we're going to be watching Calamity Jane, one of my favourite films. Oh, the Deadwood Stage is coming on over the hills, and the Indian arrows are thicker than porcupine quills. I love that movie. Once I had a secret love. Right, we're not going to do the whole score. But come along for Still Game on Friday from 2 o'clock. Somebody popped in on Wednesday to the community cafe, and they were asking them, so what happens here? And so it kind of forced me to actually put a wee leaflet together. So this is most of the stuff, not all of the stuff, but most of the stuff that's happening in February and March. So take one of these as you go. Today, if you haven't got one already, and it just hopefully will keep you updated. My apologies if something you're going to isn't on there. I've done my best, and that's all we can do. I'm delighted this morning to welcome the Reverend Michael Okpara from Nigeria this morning. He's not come all the way from Nigeria for this. He's been here in Scotland for a while. But Michael came to Scotland as a student in ministry. He came as a minister, but he came to do postgraduate studies. And liked the country so much, he wants to stay. Because he likes our weather. So Michael has now requested to become a Church of Scotland minister. And in order to do that, you have to go through a transition process where you learn things about the Church of Scotland and about the country and stuff like that. But basically it means we get a free minister for a year. Hey! So Michael officially starts tomorrow, but he wanted to come today. He'll say something next week and introduce himself. But Michael, it is an absolute joy and delight to have you with us. Welcome to St. Martin's, and we hope you enjoy your time. Okay. Last week, everybody was telling me how much they loved the hymns and how soothing they were and how gentle. This week, not so much. The first hymn, and I'm not sure, I thought everybody would know this, but I'm not sure. So the first one goes, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. Okay, so there are three groups of people at the moment. There's the group that are thinking, yeah, I haven't sung this since YF and I loved it. There's the folk that are going, never heard this in my life before. And the third group are going, I knew I should just have stayed in my bed. So the actions. Yeah. The actions are, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. Okay? We'll just hit you with the actions for the chorus. There are for the verses, but we'll just hit you with the chorus. But at the end, you can do everything was fine and dandy. Let's stand.
Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. The Lord said to Noah, there's gonna be a floody, floody. The Lord said to Noah, there's gonna be a floody, floody. Get those children out of the muddy, muddy, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine, give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. The Lord told Noah to build him an arky, arky. Lord told Noah to build him an arky, arky. Build it out of gopher barky, barky, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God children of the Lord. The animals, they came on by twosy, twosies. The animals, they came on by twosy, twosy. Elephants and kangaroos, roosies, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine. Give God the glory, glory, rise and shine. And give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. It rained and poured for 40 daisy, daisies. Rained and poured for 40 daisies, daisies. Almost drove those animals crazy, crazy, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine, give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. The sun came out and dried up the land. and dandy, dandy children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine, give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord.
Oh, that woke you up. I thought I'd press that halfway through that. Let's pray. Gracious God, as we come into this church this morning, we come with different emotions, with different feelings, with different thoughts. But we thank you that the joy of the Lord is our strength. And that even though we may not feel particularly joyful, maybe life is getting in the way. Maybe circumstances have robbed us of our joy. We know that in you, joy is always there. So Lord, help us to embrace that joy. Help us to realize, as scripture says, that sorrow is but the guest of a night, but joy cometh in the morning. And on this morning, may we praise you for the love that you have for us. We're sorry, Lord, when we wander away. We're sorry when we forget you. We're sorry when we don't tell folk just how wonderful you are. Forgive us. Restore us in your love. And help us to take every opportunity to share the good news. These and all our prayers we offer in and through the name of Jesus our Lord. And as a family, we say together the words that he taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Okay. So, did anybody watch that Ant and Dec program? I can't even remember what it's called. Unlimited Win? Limitless Win. That's it. It was on last week, the last episode. And I would have won £1.25 million if I'd been on it. I know. Mind you, you'd have had to find somebody to lead the service this morning if I had. Oh, if I won that amount of money, I would keep working. Nothing would change. Says there's a Ferrari heads up the road. So anyway, the reason I would have won £1.25 million was that one of the questions was, how many people were on the ark? Right, okay, who got it right if you were answering it? Who got it right? Okay. How many people were on the ark? And if you're thinking, Bill, I don't know, but I'm sure there's a song about that. We stand to sing if we're able. Mr. Noah built the ark. We're not going to bother. Well, I was going to say we're not going to bother with accents. Down came the rain in torrents, splish splash. Down came the rain in torrents, splish splash. Down came the rain in torrents, but only a certain number were saved. And you hold up the relevant number, but I'm not going to give you a clue. No, just yet, anyway. So let's stand.
Mr. Noah built the ark. The people thought it such a lark. Mr. Noah pleaded so, but into the ark they would not go. Down came the rain in torrents, splish splash. Down came the rain in torrents. Came the rain in torrents, and only eight were saved. The animals came in two by two, the elephant, giraffe, and the kangaroo. All were safely stowed away on that great and awful day. Down came the rain in torrents. Down came the rain in torrents. Down came the rain in torrents, and only eight were saved.
Can I say, that's the politest I've ever heard. Down came the rain in torrents, splish splash. That's very refined. In Fergus, it was down came the rain in torrents, splash splash. We'll do the animals again. The animals went in two by two, the elephant, giraffe, and the kangaroo. All were safely stowed away on that great and awful. Down came the rain in torrents. Down came the rain in torrents. Down came the rain in torrents. And only eight were saved. So whenever you see a rainbow, whenever you see a rainbow, whenever you see a rainbow, for those of you who think that you started off going to church this morning but wandered into the singing kettle by mistake, that's us done. We go back to sensible hymns from now on till the end of the service. But the whole point of this is that our reading this morning on this, the first Sunday of Lent, is from the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 9, reading from verses 8 to 17. And it will be read to us by Sandra. And just take your time. What? Ah, it's a miracle. I don't trust me either. Right.
Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, I establish my covenant with you and with your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you. The birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, all those that came out of the ark with you, every living creature on earth, I establish my covenant with your... Wait a minute. Never again will all life be destroyed by the waters of a flood. Never again will there be a flood to destroy the earth. And God said, this is a sign of the covenant I am making between me and you and everything, every living creature with you. A covenant for all the generation to come. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Whenever I see clouds over the earth and the rainbow, appears in the clouds. I will remember my covenant between me and you and all the living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy the earth, to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and rainbow will, the everlasting covenant between God and living creatures of every kind on the earth. And so God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and God and living on the earth. Amen, and thanks be to God.
So Sandra just said that was she said I read that terrible, and I just said no you didn't. That's the trooper to keep going when you're not feeling great. Okay, our next hymn is Great is Thy Faithfulness, and if we're able, we stand to sing together.
All I have need.
So we've called 111 just to be sure, but she was conscious. I'm fairly sure you're supposed to come down the front of the church with a stick and leave walking. But I know we'll all remember Sandra in our prayers during the rest of the day. And I have to say, yeah, you needed, right, talking, say hello to the person next to you for 2 Peter 2:1. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So God said to Noah, Noah, it's going to rain solidly for 40 days and 40 nights. It's going to just be constant. And people are just going to be going, oh, it's raining again. For 40 days and 40 nights, it's going to rain. And Noah, who came from Scotland, said, you mean summer? There is something about living in a country where we get a lot of rain. And that is, we get a lot of rainbows. And I have to say, and being a Glaswegian, this is sticking in my throat, but the most beautiful rainbows that I've seen have been in Edinburgh, many of them. And I remember coming out of New College and round about, you know, the bit where the old banks are, and just looking up. And the rainbow was just across the sky. And I heard the words, I trace the rainbow through the rain and feel the promise is not vain, that morn shall endless be. The words of that great hymn written in Scotland, O love that wilt not let me go. Written by a man who was going blind and had just been dumped by his fiancée because she said she couldn't face living with someone who was slowly going blind, and she called off the engagement. And on the night, the evening of his sister's wedding, he sat in his manse and wrote those words, O love that will not let me go. And even knowing that he was going blind, he knew that he would still see the love of God in his heart. And he would still see the promises of God in his life. And so he wrote those words, I trace the rainbow through the rain. And you can actually feel him doing that as he wrote those words. I trace the rainbow through the rain. Because he knew that in that rainbow was a promise. And that promise was the promise of love for God, from God for everybody. And that's why I wear this. A while back, you remember the paisley pattern waistcoat that I used to wear, which was actually older than all of my children. And it was actually older than all my children when I bought it, and I bought it in a second-hand shop. You'll be shocked to know. And it finally kind of gave up life, and so I was wearing boring waistcoats for a while. And the minister of the Hope Church in Bingham said to me one day, he said, "Bill, your waistcoats have got awfully boring." And I thought, I need to do something about this. And so I had a wee look, and I saw this. And I thought, I've got to buy one of these. And I bought it with Genesis 9 in mind. The promise of God. So every time I look at this, I remember that God loves me and God loves everybody. And what better reminder is that to have every day? And you know, we may complain that the rainbow's been kind of stolen, abducted, borrowed, whatever. I don't care. I know what it means. It means that God loves me. It means that God loves everybody. And it means God has made a covenant with us. And that's really interesting, because a covenant is not a promise. A covenant is a holy alliance. A covenant is God saying, this is written in the sky. This is my solemn word to you. And every time you see the rainbow, you'll know that God is love. 8 people were on the ark, and only 8 were saved. But through that, the whole world was saved. Through that covenant with Noah, with Abraham, with David, with Jesus, that new covenant that we are all born into. We have the promise of God in our lives. So whenever you see a rainbow, remember that God is love. Remember that God is love. I remember singing with my oldest grandchild, Holly, and I said to her, we're talking about rainbows. I said, "Oh, do you know the song?" And I sung, "Red and yellow and pink and green, orange and purple and blue. I can sing a rainbow, sing a rainbow, sing a rainbow." And she said, "Granddad, you forgot teal." So from then on, we had to sing, "Red and yellow and pink and green, purple, teal, orange and blue." Good job she didn't say magenta. But do you know, it's an interesting thought that you forgot teal. Because God didn't forget anybody. We might forget colours. We might forget other things, but God doesn't forget anybody. Eric and I were involved a long time ago. I'll show you the photographs if you haven't seen them already. And Joseph in his amazing Technicolor dream coat. And you know the bit where it said, actually, I was in Costco one day and somebody started singing that. As I walked past it, I just heard somebody going, "I close my eyes." But there's a bit that goes, "It was red and yellow and pink and brown and blue." Okay? And that was easy to remember. But later on in the same song, it goes, "It was red and yellow and pink and green and purple and right." And we were going, "I can't remember that." So we were performing in a church, and we actually wrote the colours on the balcony. Sorry, what I should say, we wrote the colours on pieces of paper and stuck them on the balcony, just in case. Bill out with spray can. So if you actually watch the performance, it goes, "It was red and yellow and pink and brown and purple and blue." Because we were forgetting them. But God never forgets, and that's the covenant. That's the covenant that he never forgets us. So next time you see the rainbow, look and think, oh, that's lovely. Or look and think, I wonder where the pot of gold is. We were looking at one the other week, and the end of the rainbow was right over the top of Portobello Police Station, which was hopeless because it's never open. But look and think of the wonder of it. Think of all the traditions and everything that comes with the rainbow. But most importantly, think that it's the sign that God loves you. God loves every single one of us. We are all part of the rainbow of his world and of his creation. So whenever you see a rainbow, remember God is love. As we continue our worship in our offering, we remain seated and we sing, "Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace." Just to let you know, the paramedics have arrived and they're just seeing to Sandra just now. Let's come before God in prayer. Let us all pray. "And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace." Gracious God, we thank you that your grace, that your glory eclipses everything that's mundane and unimportant in our lives. That the things that we get so vexed about and so worked up about grow strangely dim in your light, in your glory, in your grace. So help us, Lord, to put aside the things that would detract us from you, the things that would take us away from your love and your plan. And help us to turn our eyes upon you and to keep them there to concentrate on you and to bathe in your glorious light and love. As we bring our tithes, our gifts, our offerings before you this morning, so also we bring ourselves, that you might use us to make a difference in your world. Lord, help us to bring peace to a world that seems intent on tearing itself apart. As we see the rainbow of hope, so also let us be beacons of light and hope in our world. That people would turn away from violence towards each other in love and in unity. Lord, we pray for those struggling with illness this morning. We pray for those known to us, and in the silence of our hearts, we name them before you. Lord, we pray for Sandra, that you would lay your healing hand upon her. We thank you for the paramedics, for all the emergency services, for the work that they do day in, day out, often a thankless task. But Lord, we pray that you would bless them, and we thank you for each and every one of them. Lord, we pray for those who walk in this world without light, who feel that the world has passed them by, who feel that they're just in darkness. Lord, reach out with that light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never put it out, that they might know your love. They might trace your rainbow through the rain. Lord, as we prepare to go from this place, your people into your world, send us out with that great commission to make all nations your disciples. But also, Lord, remind us of the promise that you are with us always, even till the end of the age. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our final hymn is "When We Walk With the Lord in the Light of His Word, What a Glory He Sheds on Our Way. Trust and Obey." And we stand to sing if we're able. So go in peace, keep alive the faith, and the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and those whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen. Please be seated. We have some bread left from Wednesday. If anybody would like to take some, there's some white and there's some wholemeal, and there'll be more. It's all gone. Oh, sorry. Ignore that. It's all gone. But there'll be more on Wednesday.